Hello there, this is Matt from JetBrains, and I'm going to show you why JetBrains Rider is a great external script editor for Unity. Rider is a cross-platform C# development environment that has specific support for Unity. As you can see, when you open a Unity project in Rider, you'll get a familiar view of your project, just like you're used to in Unity, looking at assets and packages, rather than a more traditional view of C# projects and solutions. From here, you can browse the assets in your project, as well as view the contents of the packages folder. You can also see the read-only reference packages and browse any source code they contain. But Rider has a much better and faster way of navigating around your code. The Shift-Shift keyboard shortcut brings up the Search Everywhere dialog, which can be used to quickly find files, classes, and symbols within your project. It can also be used to search for actions, like menu items or settings, so you don't need to learn every keyboard shortcut to be productive. Once inside a script file, you can use the GoToMember action to search for methods and properties. And you can easily jump between files with the Recent Files or Recent Locations actions. Just type to filter and quickly find the file you're looking for. The Navigate To menu shows you more navigation options based on the current context, such as navigating to derived or base classes. And you can even navigate to decompile code, so you can view classes like mono behavior as decompiled C#. More powerfully, the Find Usages action will show you where a symbol is being used much faster and more accurately than a plain text search. You might have noticed these links at the top of methods or besides fields. This is Rider's Code Vision feature, and it is useful for showing version control information or usage counts, and clicking the link will quickly navigate to those usages. Rider shows extra information for Unity projects. Rider will recognize and highlight mono behavior classes as well as event functions. Clicking the link here will show documentation, either installed locally or online. But Rider takes this further. Rider will analyze your scenes, assets, and prefabs and find where these classes and methods are used. Clicking the link will show which scene or asset is using a class and navigate to it in Unity, showing a list of usages in a new editor window and highlighting the owning game object in the hierarchy window. Even cooler, Rider recognizes serialized fields in your classes and also knows what values these fields have. Clicking the link now shows where in your project the values are being used and will navigate to the game object in the Unity editor. And because Rider knows when your methods are used as event handlers in a scene, renaming the method with one of Rider's many automatic code refactorings will also update the usage in the Unity scene. No more broken references due to unexpected renames. One of the key strengths of Rider is its code analysis. Rider will inspect your code looking for issues to make sure your code is more consistent and more correct. Rider looks at many different things, from naming standards and code style to new language features and possible runtime errors. When Rider finds an issue, it'll highlight it as a warning or a suggestion, and the Alt-Enter keyboard shortcut can very quickly rewrite your code to fix the issue. And again, Rider has great Unity support here, with many Unity-specific inspections, all designed to find issues while you type before you switch back to the Unity editor. Simple examples, such as calling new on a mono-behavior or scriptable object, or warnings if a coroutine, tag, layer, or scene name can't be found. Rider will provide code completion, navigation, find usages, and even rename support for these magic strings. A top tip while using Rider is to find out why an inspection is being shown. For example, Rider tells you not to use null coalescing operators on Unity objects. Why not? Use Alt-Enter, and under the Inspection Options menu, you'll find Why is Rider suggesting this?, which will take you to a web page explaining what the warning means and how to avoid the issue. Rider also includes a number of inspections to easily solve simple performance-related issues. For example, empty update methods, or using compare tag instead of comparing against a string literal, or avoiding repeated use of properties that call into native code when the value hasn't changed. In fact, Rider has taken Unity's own best practices for performance and embedded them directly into the editor so that you can see when you're doing something that might have a performance impact. Rider knows that update methods are called very frequently and will highlight them to remind you to avoid expensive API calls. Rider even propagates this information, so any methods you call from an update method and any methods they call will also be highlighted as being frequently called. Inside a frequently called method, Rider will highlight expensive actions, such as calling getComponent, debug.log, or even comparing Unity objects against null. But it's important to point out that these aren't errors or warnings. This isn't necessarily bad code. Rider will let you know that these are expensive operations, but it is up to you to decide if this causes issues for your game. The best thing to do is to profile. And Rider has tooling to help here too, with a profiler that is focused on your code and can trace your code in the editor or in a standalone player. It also allows you to do what-if analysis. What if I optimize this method? Will it have a major impact? Is it worth spending the time on the optimization? Rider also helps you work faster by helping you to write and generate code. Smart code completion will add using statements for you, so you can just type and Rider will handle the rest. And of course, Rider will auto-complete Unity's event functions as you type. Or you can use the Generate menu, which has lots of options to automatically generate boilerplate code, such as constructors, properties, equality, and more. You can also use it to generate multiple event functions at once. And you can use, edit, and create live templates to quickly generate code snippets. Rider ships with several Unity-specific templates to quickly generate attributes, log messages, serialized fields, and more. Speaking of serialized fields, you can simply use Alt-Enter to quickly add and remove inspector attributes. And there are file templates too, to create a new mono behavior, tests, assembly definition files, and so on, complete with meta files. We've already seen some of Rider's Unity integration, but Rider has more to offer. By default, Rider will track changes to your scripts and tell Unity to refresh the asset database, and so compile your code in the background. No more waiting for code to compile when you switch back to Unity. Let's reduce the time it takes to switch between Unity and your script editor. You can also control the editor's play mode from within Rider with these buttons in the toolbar. You can toggle between play and edit mode, hit pause and step through frames, all while still in the script editor. And Rider will bring the Unity console into the script editor too. Much of the logging you'll add to your game is heavily related to scripts, so bring it into the script editor. And you can easily navigate to your code from the stack traces. Let's take a look at debugging. As you'd expect, everything is automatically configured for Unity projects, and you can just click the debug button to attach to the Unity editor and start debugging your project. You can use the buttons in the toolbar to switch to play mode, or you can select the attach and play configuration to automatically switch to play mode when you start debugging. Breakpoints are easily added by clicking the text gutter, and you can right-click to show advanced options, such as logging, conditions and hit counts, and even dependent breakpoints, which means a breakpoint is inactive until another breakpoint is hit first, which is a great tool to handle complex debugging. When a breakpoint is hit, Rider shows debug values directly on the editor surface, and you can use the variables pane to get more information. Rider even provides extended information for scenes and game objects. If we look at the current scene here, we can see that Rider gives us a list of the top-level game objects. Drilling in shows us the child game objects, giving us a debugger view of the same details as the hierarchy tool window in Unity. We can even see the components attached to the game object. One very cool feature of Rider is the ability to see decompiled code in the debugger just by clicking on the frame in the stack window. Even better, you can set a breakpoint and decompile code, and debug Unity or other third-party code just like you'd debug your own. This is really helpful when you can't see why an API isn't working as you'd expect. And of course, you can debug standalone players, on the desktop or on a device, mobile, tablet, or console, attached to the current network. Rider is the first script editor to support unit testing for Unity. Any tests that use the Unity API must run inside a Unity process, but the code for the test lives in an external editor. Rider's mission is to reduce the time you spend switching between Unity and your script editor, and so Rider will run the tests in the Unity editor for you, but show progress and results in Rider, where you're actually working on the tests. And that's just a quick look at some of the features that Rider has. There are loads more features that we haven't looked at, such as literally thousands of quick fixes, context actions, and automated code refactorings. Version control integration, with support from Git to Perforce. And local history, the career-saving feature that allows you to roll back to code changes made in between commits. Database tooling. The file structure window. Bookmarks, code cleanup, hundreds of plugins, documentation and videos. And yes, there is a dark mode. Rider is available for Windows, Mac, and Linux with the same features and experience on all platforms. Download it today and give it a try. Thanks for watching.